Hello everyone and welcome back once again. Today we will make eggless chessboard cake. This is the most creative cake making and as the name suggests, it has a chessboard pattern in it. This is very delicious and very yummy. So let's start baking. But before that, I would request you all to please subscribe to my channel, press the bell icon and like and share the video. Let's start baking now. For this we need two sponge cakes, one vanilla and one chocolate. For a vanilla sponge cake, we will first sieve 250 grams of maida. To it we will add 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder and we will also add 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. We will sift it together now and we will sift our dry ingredients 2 times so that our cake rises well and is very spongy and fluffy. Now after our dry ingredients, we will move on to our wet ingredients. For this, we will first take 300 ml of milk at room temperature. To it, we will add 250 grams of powdered sugar, normal powdered sugar. We will whisk it well. Now to this we will add 150 ml of oil. Now we will add 1/2 teaspoon of vinegar. This is optional. If you want, you can skip this also. And we will add 2.5 teaspoon of vanilla essence. Give it a good mix now. We will now add our dry ingredients in 2 batches. So that there are no lumps in our batter. Mix it well and now goes in our second batch. Mix it well again and our batter is now ready. Here I have taken an 8-inch round tin. I have lined it with the parchment paper and I have greased the sides with oil. You can use butter if you don't have the parchment paper. You can also use oil if you want. Now we will pour in our batter. Tap it twice and this will go in the preheated oven at 180 degrees Celsius for around 30 to 35 minutes. Make a note that every oven is different, so kindly check after 25 minutes. After approximately 10 to 12 minutes, our cake has risen and is brown. It's perfect from top. We will now turn off the top element and will bake it only on lower element so that the top surface of the cake doesn't get burned or hard. We will now continue our baking for next 20 to 25 minutes or until our cake is ready. Our cake is now ready. See how spongy it is. If the cracks are there on the cake, do not worry. This is a perfect sign that our cake has risen well. We will now demold it and will move to our next step, that is making of a chocolate sponge cake. For a chocolate sponge cake, the whole procedure, all the ingredients are the same as the vanilla sponge cake. Instead of vanilla essence, I have added here 4 tablespoons of cocoa powder. This is the only change which I have done in the batter. Our batter is now ready. We will again line the tin with the parchment paper and we will bake our cake in it. I am using the same mold because the shape of both the cakes and the size should exactly be the same. Now both our cakes are ready. We will move to a further step. We will now level our cake by cutting the top of the cake. Cut it gently. We will now remove the top layer. And now we will divide our cake in 2 halves, in 2 equal halves. Do it very carefully and slowly as we will be needing 2 equal halves for our chess cake, for making our chess board cake. You can have a look at the sponginess of the cake. In the same way, we will divide our chocolate cake into 2 halves. We now move to our final step, that is making of the chess board pattern. We now need to cut all the 4 layers of our cake into rings I am not using here any cookie cutter because it's not practical for anyone to buy a cookie cutter for a single cake. So I am using simple home kitchen utensils for making this. Here I am using a round tin in order to cut a ring. According to the size of your cake, you can choose any utensil which you have. Make sure that the knife goes vertically and not slanting, otherwise the rings will not be equal in size. Very carefully, you now need to remove the ring from the base. Our ring is now ready, the outer ring. We will cut one more ring from this now. I'm using a katori for this. And now we will take out this ring also. So from one layer of cake, we will make three rings. Now we will move to the most interesting part. This is assembling of the chessboard. This is the outer ring of the vanilla sponge cake. Into it, we will put our chocolate sponge cake, the middle layer, and in the center, we will again put the vanilla sponge cake. So our first layer is now ready. We will now coat it with our ganache. The link of chocolate ganache is in the description box, and the same is right now highlighting in the top right corner of the screen. Spread it evenly. The layer should not be too thick or too thin. Now we will put our second layer on it. We will now put the chocolate layer first, the chocolate ring first, followed by vanilla and then again chocolate. Please follow the pattern carefully. We will now again layer it up with chocolate ganache. Now we move on to our third step. Now we will have vanilla followed by chocolate cake and then again vanilla cake. Layer it evenly with ganache. And now we will have our fourth and final layer, chocolate followed by vanilla and then again chocolate. I am sure when you will make this cake and when you will serve it to someone, they will be like, how did you make this? This is amazing. We will again coat it with ganache, but this layer of ganache will be a bit thick in comparison to the other three layers. You can use a spatula or the back of the knife. We need to cover the sides also. And we will keep it in the refrigerator for 15 minutes so that it sets well. Now comes the fun part, making of the chessboard. We now need few strips of 2 cm each. It depends on what is the diameter of your cake. Place the strips as shown in the video, leaving some gap in between. We will now sprinkle powdered sugar over it. The sugar should be powdered very, very evenly, and I'm using a sieve to do so that the layer is even. Gently remove the strips one by one. Be very slow in this process or you will ruin your cake. We will now place the strips on the white sugar part. And now we will sprinkle some cocoa powder on it. It should be a good layer, and I am again using a sieve for this so that the layer is even. We have to repeat these steps 3 to 4 times. That is removing the strips and again keeping it in some different pattern. Just follow the video and the result will be amazing. We will now make a crisscross pattern on the cake. Dust it with some powdered sugar again, a generous layer of it, so that a chocolate ganache is not seen. We will now again make a crisscross pattern by covering all the cocoa portions. And now it's done. Isn't it amazing? Just clean the sides of the plate and our cake is ready. I will cut a slice and I will show it to you. Just have a look at the beautiful chessboard pattern cake. Wow, this looks heavenly good. I hope you all like the video. Please do drop a comment in the comment section after trying the recipe. Do like it, share it, subscribe to the channel. We'll be back with another recipe. Until then, take care, goodbye, and happy baking!